doesn't have to be unfair. Poverty isn't inevitable. Things can and they will change. Thank you very much.
My colleague, yeah, he was a complete outsider. He's here, and they don't know how to react to either.
지난 30여 년간 대중의 주목을 끌지 못했던 제레미 코빈.
He has worked out in opposition virtually continually what he thinks.
I think the politics of this country has been poisoned and ruined by the politics of personality, celebrity and personal abuse.
How did he get to this?
당내에서도 비주류이던 그가 노동당 대표로 당선돼 영국 정계 중심에 섰다.
Thank you very much.
지금 그를 선택한 영국의 민심은 무엇일까? 양당 정치의 나라 영국. 매주 수요일은 세간의 이목이 의회로 집중된다. 야당 대표가 총리에게 날선 질문을 던지는 의회 질의가 있는 까닭이다. 그 자리에 처음 선 코빈은 그다운 방식으로 질문을 준비해 왔다.
I sent out an email to thousands of people and asked them what questions they would like to put to the Prime Minister. And I received 40,000 replies. 2,500 people emailed me about the housing crisis in this country. And I asked one from a woman called Marie, who says, What does the government intend to do about the chronic lack of affordable housing and the extortionate rents charged by some private sector landlords in this country? I had more than 1,000 questions on tax credits. Paul, for example, says this very heartfelt question, why is the government taking tax credits away from families? We need this money to survive so our children don't suffer.
And in fact, a lot of journalists are very cross, saying it's his job to hold the government to account and make Cameron squirm at this point, and we want punch-ups and things. And his argument is, well, no, I'm actually reflecting what the people want. They've asked me.
코빈은 첫 의회 질의에서 대중의 목소리를 들으라는 메시지를 던졌다. 그는 어떤 정치인이었을까? 런던 북부 이슬링턴. 런던이 확장되면서 한적한 주택단지로 개발되기 시작한 외곽 동네다. 30여 년 동안 이 지역 사람들은 하원 선거에서 오직 한 명만을 선택했다.
So he's a good guy. We love him.
Have you ever met him?
Yeah, I do meet him personally. The other day he was riding a bike and I was driving. So I see him, I have to give him away. And he was just like, hi, how are you doing? He actually knows me. He's a good guy.
지역의 대표 코빈에 대한 신뢰는 견고했다.
Is out to help real working class people like myself. He manages to understand people in similar situations to himself, and he reaches out to wider audiences. If it's upper class, lower class, or middle class, and everyone understands his agenda that he's trying to tackle poverty and help all the people that are in need within London and all over the United Kingdom.
코빈은 지난 1983년 33살에 처음 하원의원으로 당선됐다. 이후 8선 의원직을 지켜온 데는 지역민과의 소통과 교감이 큰 몫을 했다.
Well, he's honest. That's what it is. He's all honest.
Have you ever met him before?
Always. When I've got problems, it's his place I go to. I always go and see him. I've got problems with housing, work issues. Anything you want to know, he can help you with. Every time I voted, for anybody to be in the Labour Party thing in this area, I've always voted him.
You know he is the leader of Labour Party now?
Yes.
What do you expect from him?
No different, he'll be exactly the same. He'll be honest, he'll do what he believes is right and he'll stick by it. He won't give you no rubbish, he'll stick by what he says.
주택과 공원 한쪽에 위치한 지역구 사무실. 출입문 앞에 그의 일정표가 공지돼 있었다.
야, 이 사람은 리더인데도 아직도 주민들 만나서 상담하고 이런 거 하네.
주민과의 만남은 다음 달까지 이미 잡혀 있다. 지역구 내에서 코빈에 대한 지지는 나이와 인종을 넘어선 듯 보였다.
Everybody from the community helps him. And everybody from the community, he helps them. Anybody, you name it, any background, any color. He stands up for them. You go and see him for help. And he's always there. He's always there for help.
What do you think of the Tory government?
Well, their politics is basically based on something that no one can understand. They're just there for rich people, that's it. When I talk about conservative, they're a bunch of rich people. It could change a lot of things in the politics, yes.
We like all Somali Muslim Tory community like Jericho.
Future Prime Minister, Governor.
하지만 5개월 전까지만 해도 그는 영국 정치계의 아웃사이더였다. 지난 80년대 중반, 데이빗은 새내기 기자였다. 당시 코빈의 지역구인 이슬링턴에 살았던 인연으로 그 후 30여 년간 그의 행보를 취재해왔다.
Basically, I'd come across him at on one or two meetings, and he's quite interesting because he's quite soft-spoken, as the public can see, but very radical.
지하철 출근이 일상적인 영국 하원 의원들, 넥타이의 정장만큼은 고수한다. 그들 사이에서 제레미 코빈은 이단하였다.
The man insisting on higher sartorial standards from his fellow members is Tory MP Terry Dix. He says that Labour scruffs like Robin Corbyn should be barred from addressing the House unless they pull their socks up.
It's not a fashion parade, it's not a gentleman's club, it's not a banker's institute. It's a place where the people are represented.
Is that the jumper that your mum made?
Yes, it is.
She didn't make the shirt as well, I suppose.
No, she didn't make the shirt. That came from the co-op. But the jumper she knitted, and it's very comfortable, and it's perfect for this kind of weather, because I'm hopping in and out of buildings all day long, going to meetings and different places, and it's just perfect for the winter weather. Late at night here, it's quite disgusting. After the dinners are over and the division bell rings for 10 o'clock, there's fleets of limousines draw up, and out get large Tory MPs with even larger stomachs wearing dinner jackets, and they stride in to vote.
Well, you're not jealous?
Not at all, because I turn down dinner invitations all the time. I don't think that's the job of an MP. The job of an MP is to represent their people.
Most politicians, when they get into power or a strong position, even in Westminster, want the big house, the more than one house. They've got an eye on business opportunities and things like that, even in the Labour Party, people like this. And Corbyn has none of this at all. I mean, no one can get him for basically saying he's after, you know, living a grand style of living. In fact, that's one of his great appeals. It just seems an ordinary person who does things.
기존 정치인과는 다른 코빈을 사람들이 주목하기 시작했다.
But suddenly people have got fed up and they want to change and they want someone who's going to be articulate about it and straightforward and say what he means. I mean, people are really fed up with politicians who never say what they mean in this country.
노동당 대표로 나선 코빈은 솔직하고 직설적인 목소리로 대중을 대변했다.
The Tories have used the economic crisis of 2008 to impose a terrible burden on the poorest people in this country. Those that have seen their wages frozen or cut, those that can't afford to even sustain themselves properly, those that rely on food banks to get by. It's not right, it's not necessary, and it's got to change.
두 차례의 세계 대전을 거친 영국은 피폐해진 국민에게 무상 복지를 약속했다. 이른바 요람에서 무덤까지 국가가 보장하겠다는 것. 그러나 70년대 말 대처의 보수당은 민영화와 복지 축소를 내세운 영국식 신자유주의를 택했다. 교육과 주택에 대한 보조금도 폐지됐다. 세 번이나 총선에 승리한 총리를 향해 30대의 젊은 의원 코빈은 거침없는 비판을 쏟아냈다.
Will the Prime Minister accept that 10 years ago in 1979 there were 2,750 households in temporary accommodation in London
The current figure is over 25,000, and a further 2,000 people are sleeping on the streets. Does she not agree that people sleeping on the streets of our capital city, being charged exorbitant rents, and children being brought up in bed and breakfast hotels, is a disgrace to a civilised country?
Mr. Speaker, I announce very considerable extra expenditure to relieve homelessness. The Honourable Member will also be aware.
대처 이후로 영국의 신자유주의 기조는 크게 달라지지 않았다. 90년대 말 노동당이 집권하지만 토니 블레어의 중도 노선은 양극화를 가속화시킬 뿐이었다. 2010년 재집권한 보수당은 강도 높은 긴축 정책을 밀어붙였다. 지난 30여 년간 축적된 불평등의 그림자가 사람들의 삶에 짙게 스며들었다.
That cloud hangs over a feeble economic recovery that was noted over the past year. Some job creation, some economic growth. The biggest problem is the underlying problem behind all the issues you just mentioned, behind tax evasion, behind unemployment or concealed unemployment, and behind financial fragility. And it's an issue of inequality. It has become a very divided system and a system where the wealth is not equally distributed.
규제 철폐, 투자 축소로 인해 제조업이 무너지고 금융산업만 비대해졌다. 결국 2008년 금융위기의 여파로 서민의 삶은 바닥을 쳤다.
2008 and 2009 was not caused by single parents, was not caused by nurses, was not caused by teachers, not caused by people that sweep the streets. It was caused by an under-regulated banking system, by grotesque profit-making and telephone number salaries for the chief executive. Yeah. Yeah.
런던 교외에서 운송업을 하는 서삼웅 씨. 30년 전 유학생으로 왔다가 영국인 아내와 결혼해 정착했다.
그때는 그렇게 많이 힘들지 않았어요. 왜냐하면 물가도 쌌고 그리고 또 월급 받는 비해서 물가가 그렇게 많이 힘들지 않았어요. 근데 지금은 월급을 받는 데서 물가가 너무 많이 비싸니.
첫째와 둘째는 독립해 따로 살고 지금은 막내딸 현아랑 세 식구다. K-POP을 좋아한다는 현아는 작년에 대학을 졸업했다.
Even now, what is the biggest stress is to you at the moment?
Mainly travel costs and also trying to find a job to sustain living even. Because obviously you want to go out, you have to pay phone bills, you have to try and pay your transport even, and if you can't get a job, it's very hard. And for this past month, I've applied at about 30 jobs and still not heard anything from any of them. So in the long run, it's hard for me to be able to support myself.
Why are you thinking this? Are you having a hard time now?
Conservatives make things easier for the rich people. If you're rich, then these cuts to NHS, to like putting up tuition fees, it's not really going to affect you. But for people who do rely on the benefits, for students and everyone else that doesn't have the luxury of having been born into these riches.
정치에 무관심했던 서삼웅 씨도 최근 노동당에서 돌풍을 일으킨 인물은 안다. 현아가 부쩍 정치 이야기를 많이 하기 때문이다.
I don't know because I just worry about because I'm not, I don't know how long I'm living in this country, but young generation is worried about it. But you'll be, they will be surviving, all countries survive.
We'll survive once we get rid of him. Everything's been worse since he came into power.
Right, put it that way. If it is worse, why people keep voting? Why? Because of rich people.
No.
That's a problem.
No, if you looked at the statistics, when they had the vote for... we actually researched this, me and Annie.
Yeah.
If you look at the statistics, London itself the majority, like 95% voted Labour Party in. All the surrounding areas, like up north and down south, all voted Conservative, which is why he got in. But London itself voted for Labour.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't affect the people up north and up south as much.
Exactly, not only that, because in London, inside London, there are poor people living in there, they got a lot of, like, they come from another country and they are try living there.
Not necessarily.
현아 또래의 젊은 층이 정치에 관심을 갖게 만든 것도 코빈이 만들어낸 현상 중 하나다.
I only recently looked at politics in the news. I didn't really care much about politics in the past because I thought it was too difficult for me personally to comprehend everything. He's trying to find solutions where it's not going to affect all of us at once and put us further in a crisis.
Are you going to vote him in his, if he tried to be a prime minister in the country?
I don't usually vote, but I think it would, if he was running, it would make me want to vote in the long run.
지난 7일 맨체스터에서 열린 대규모 시위. 영국 전역에서 모여든 수많은 군중은 복지삭감 반대의 목소리를 높였다. 집권 1기 시절 보수당은 영국 국민건강보험 NHS까지 일부 민영화했다. 대처도 손대지 못했던 NHS의 민영화 추진은 노인들까지 거리로 나서게 만들었다.
Because there are private companies making lots of money from parts of the NHS being privatised.
What do I want? I want to see no more privatisation in the NHS.
NHS에 대한 영국인들의 자부심은 대단하다. 지난 2012년 런던 올림픽 개막식에서 세계인에게 자랑한 NHS는 1948년 시작된 영국의 무상의료 체계다. 시위 군중이 도착한 곳. 경찰의 삼엄한 경계가 막아섰다. 그곳에선 집권 2기 6개월째로 접어든 보수당 전당대회가 열리고 있었다.
Shame on you! Shame on you!
Tory scum! Tory scum!
복지삭감에 반대하는 코빈의 당선 이후 시민들의 메시지는 더욱 명확해졌다.
I will send a very clear message to the Tories who are holding their conference just behind us now, where they will be debating and discussing policies that will lead to further destruction of our National Health Service.
What I do know is there is health inequality within our society because of poverty, because of debt, and there is a longer life expectancy for the richer than the poorer. There are many things to be conquered in health issues, but the very principle of a health service as a right and free at the point of use is surely something that we can all be proud of.
보수당 전당대회 기간 내내 시위 군중이 거리를 점령했다.
'Cause he's for the people
just like we are.
We support Jeremy Corbyn because he's anti-austerity, anti-war, he's for the people. What you see is what you get, 100%.
If Jeremy Corbyn carries on the way he is doing and he doesn't back down on anything, then I may be prepared to give him a chance.
It'll be a very difficult thing, I'd say, for him to be able to put through all of the properly moral policies that he would like to see implemented. The powers behind the whole capitalist system are so great, as in, let's say, the oil industry, the industrial military industry.
Into the spotlight. 코빈은 지금 더 허리띠를 졸라매야 할 때라는 보수당 정책이 틀렸다고 말했다. 턱걸이로 후보 등록을 했던 그의 지지율은 단숨에 1위로 올라섰다. 돌풍이었다.
And also, people started joining the Labour Party. I mean, even in this town, which is a very, very conservative town. And suddenly said, oh, we're joining and we're going to vote for Jeremy Corbyn. And it wasn't just young people, it was also older people, people about my age as well, who suddenly said, I'm fed up with the Labour Party always apologising for itself, and at least this chap knows where he stands. And basically it just snowballed, it became a sort of Corbyn mania. I called him Storming Corbyn, because he was quite soft-spoken. But the way he did so well absolutely shocked and frightened all the other candidates.
중도 노선을 지지하는 블레어 전 총리까지 코빈 죽이기에 나섰다. 지지 세력은 오히려 당 밖에 있었다. 영국 경제학자 41명이 코빈을 지지하고 나선 것이다.
At the same time, his economic program, although not liked by some members of the Labour Party, for example, the Blairites, those who were following Tony Blair and his cabinet. So although it's not liked by the Labour Party itself, is actually shared or supported, even if quietly, outside the Labour Party.
노동당 밖에 젊고 새로운 지지층이 조용히 늘고 있는 곳은 대학가다. 지난 2010년 등록금 인상 법안이 통과됐을 때 학생들은 분노했다. 빚으로 대학을 다니고 졸업 후엔 일자리를 찾아 헤매야 하는 이들에게도 돌파구가 필요했다.
I like him, yeah. I think he attracts people because people believe he's going to be true to his word. He's not really going to compromise on that.
I'm going to come out of it in about 60 grand of debt. And I don't know how we're going to be able to pay that back in the long run. I was also the first year for it to be £9,000 a year. And I think it's definitely going to have an effect. Will I get them paid for by the government? But then when I graduate, when I start earning over £21,000, that's when I had to start gradually paying it back. They kind of shot themselves in the foot there because the job market isn't great. I don't know when it is that I'll actually be earning over £21,000. So I don't know when it is that I'll start paying the money back to them.
이런 학생들의 고민을 정치가 해결해 줘야 한다고 말했다.
Reducing care for the elderly, destroying the hopes of young people for a college education, or putting university graduates into massive debt. They want the people of Britain to accept all these things. Well, they're not having it. Our Labour Party says no.
코빈은 기존 정치인들이 피하거나 덮어두려 했던 문제들을 주저없이 공약으로 채택했다. 해마다 오르는 요금 인상의 해결 방법으로 철도 공영화를 내세웠다. 핵심은 정부의 재정 긴축에 반대한다는 것. 오히려 의료와 교육 등 공공 지출을 늘리고 철도와 에너지 등은 공영화하겠다고 선언했다.
One is that this is an anti-austerity policy. So it is saying that austerity cannot work, cuts will not deliver a balanced budget in the UK. There is no point in doing austerity because it is counterproductive, and therefore we need another alternative policy. The alternative policy is to instead invest, to go for growth, to increase wages, to increase the level of employment, to therefore produce more tax revenues, to therefore produce a stronger economy in that way.
Jeremy Corbyn. I don't think there should be.
그의 경제 공약은 선거 기간 내내 좌편향에 이상적일 뿐이라며 공격받았다.
We are really going to be able to deliver the schools, the hospitals, the transport infrastructure. We've got to be credible enough to properly pay for it. We cannot do that if we just promise to print money we haven't got. It's dishonest, it's false promise. We've got to offer people real hope instead.
We went into the last election promising cuts. We went into the 2010 election promising cuts. Are we going to go into a 2020 election, because Osborne will not have balanced the books by that stage, saying, well, an incoming Labour government, the first thing we've got to do is make more cuts in order to make ourselves credible. I say invest to grow. Yes, you can't cut your way to prosperity. You grow your way.
What you want to do with a weak economy or a weakened economy like Britain's has been is support demand, support government spending, support people earning a decent wage, not gradually try and undermine all of that, which is what the spending cuts amount to. So on the economy, what Jeremy Corbyn is saying is far closer to the mainstream of economic thought compared to the government. The government are the radicals, the government are the extremists.
노동당 기득권 세력 및 주류 언론과는 달리 민심은 코빈을 선택했다. 59.5%, 역대 최고 지지율의 압도적 1위였다.
For Jeremy Corbyn to be addressing overflowing halls, streets, young activists, what does that feel like to you now?
Exciting, very exciting, because it shows that there is a huge gap in the political conversation held by political parties in Westminster and the way in which the parliament system operates and the views and aspirations of a lot of young people.
Is it good for you? Did you always dream of being a leader, a prime minister?
I'm not somebody that goes through life measuring myself against this benchmark, that benchmark or the other benchmark. I measure myself against what we're achieving as a society and a community.
For a long time, political science and politics and the media have treated political parties as electoral machines, as basically organizations whose function is only to articulate, gather interest in society, represent them with the purpose of winning elections. And this primary function of parties was always thought to be, for until now, the electoral winning. On the other hand, I think what is significant about the election of Jeremy Corbyn is that it shows us why people choose to commit to political parties in the first place.
왜 코빈을 지지하는가? 그 답은 첫 의회 질의에서 찾을 수 있었다.
Many told me that they thought Prime Minister's question time was too theatrical, that Parliament was out of touch and too theatrical, and they wanted things done differently, but above all, they wanted their voice heard in Parliament. So I thought my first Prime Minister's question time, I'd do it in a slightly different way, and I'm sure the Prime Minister is going to absolutely welcome this. I had more than 1,000 questions on tax credits. Paul, for example, says this very heartfelt question: why is the government taking tax credits away from families? We need this money to survive so our children don't suffer.
He would have probably expected some highfalutin policy question and didn't get it, you know, or challenging him on Syria or something like that. And it didn't happen. And you could tell Cameron was really puzzled. And I looked at, when I was watching this,
I received over 1,000 questions on the situation facing our mental health services and people that suffer from mental health conditions. This is a very, very serious situation across the whole country, and I want to put to the Prime Minister a question that was put to me quite simply from Gail. Do you think it's acceptable that the mental health services in this country are on their knees at the present time?
세계 신자유주의의 중심 국가이던 영국. 30년 비주류 좌파 의원의 화려한 부상은 무엇을 의미할까?
한국에서는 저런 인물이 없느냐라는 얘기를 하는 분들이 탄탄한 분들 가끔 계셨어요. 저는 그건 번지수를 잘못 찾은 점인 것 같고요. 우리도 그 이번에 노동당의 입당, 영국 노동당의 입당에서 그 에너지를 발휘했던 영국 청년들처럼, 그다음에 지금 미국에서도 버니 샌더스를 지지하는 굉장히 강력한 그 자발적인 대중운동의 흐름이 있거든요. 이런 운동의 흐름을 만들어내가는 그런 대중운동이 생겨나는 게 그게 관건이겠죠. 어떤 인물이 아니고요.
코빈의 대반란이 성공할지는 미지수다. 분명한 것은 더 이상 소수의 기득권층을 위해 다수가 빈곤과 불평등을 참지 않겠다는 강력한 신호를 보내고 있다는 사실이다.
거기서 내건 그 구호들과 정책들이 굉장히 지금 현재 한국에서 그 어떤 정당도 실험하지, 과감하게 내걸고 있지 못한 그런 상황 속에서 그것들이 사람들한테 먹힌다는 거. 분명히 이제 신자유주의에 대한 반란들은 있을 것이고 그런 것들이 이제 우리한테도 좀 고무적으로 다가올 수 있지 않을까.
Rather than thinking about what is the movement that brings them what they are, what concerns in society parties respond to, how do they articulate these concerns, how do they turn them into principles, and what kind of principled battles they find. What I think is significant is not so much the views of the individual, but why that individual was represented in the first place and what he represents. So who gets the chance to win when there's nothing more?